partially from ocean-bound plastics collected within 30 minutes of coastlines and marine environments. Oh, Earth's pristine, precious oceans deserve to be pristine, and we're dedicated to doing our part. This bag was knitted with 100% recycled materials. Learn more at rothys.com/sustainability/bags. That's part of the reason that I wanted really to get these bags is because I can, the main reason is that I can wash them. I was thinking about getting a luxury makeup bags, but you can't really wash those. And then also the sustainability aspect I find really cool. Now test the care. If your bag has a base insert, remove it first. And if your bag has hardware, use the accompanying wash bag, which I guess that's the wash bag. I'll open it in a second. Then it's business as usual. Toss your bag and insert in the wash bag, if applicable, into the washing machine. Use cold water, mild detergent, and the delicate cycle. No heat, please. Let your bag air dry inside. Not quite right. We can't have that. If needed, you have 30 days to return or exchange. Even though I think this was a final sale, to be honest with you, because I got it at a very discounted price. All original packaging required. This tag must be attached to the bag in order to return it. Rothys.com/returns. Good to know. If your bag features hardware, it may come with a wash bag. This helps prevent scuffing while in the washing machine. So, like I said, I haven't washed any of my stuff yet, but I'm going to. Now I am going to open this bag. Okay. Oh, look at this. Okay. Now it comes. It's all gray inside, but as you can see, it says Rothy's, and this is actually stitched on. This is stitched on. It's not a sticker or anything. And I really like this a lot. I like the gray compartment. I feel like this is going to be fabulous for all of my makeup brushes. Now, I don't necessarily have to take all of my makeup brushes, but, you know, I can certainly add makeup brushes and maybe, like, you know, some other stuff here. I mean, I just really wanted large bags to be able to easily travel with my stuff. Now, it is pretty wide. I don't have the dimensions with me at this moment. I'm sorry. I don't have the dimensions, but, it is pretty big. It is the largest one they have of this design. Now, what I like is the fact that it's gray, and then you also have this green pattern throughout. Now, Rothy's is known for having a little blue tag, or it's not really a tag, like a blue embellishment on all of their items. So, like, their shoes have this, their bags. I personally think it's precious. And then this is the bottom of the bag. And I like it. I really do like these bags. Now, I will admit, I'm not, like, over the moon with the color choices. I'll say that much. But the fact that I can wash these, and the fact that they are sustainable because they're using plastic bottles that would have gone to the ocean, I'm okay with the colors. And quite honestly, like, when you are traveling with makeup brushes, it's not, you're gonna get your bag dirty, so I need something I could wash. And it's probably gonna get stained, but I'm okay with that because at least it'll be clean, you know? Now, it did come with something. I'm not quite sure what this is. much to love. Learn more about the superb craftsmanship, sustainable materials, and special care for your Rothy's bag at rothys.com /sustainability/bags. So that's cool. And this is all. Is very good on these bags. honestly, I'm really impressed. Which I really shouldn't be because I have one of their other bags too, so. So this is the big mama. Now these came together. So it's not like if I purchased three bags. Two purchases, but these were a set. And they had different patterns that you could choose from, but you couldn't mix and match, if that makes sense. Like, this was a bundle, and then they had another bundle, and it's not like if I liked another bag, I could switch it. No, that's what it was. Now, this one has the blue little detailing right here. Yeah, and they only have it on one side. 10% off code. If that's the case, I'll link it down below for you guys if you're interested. Like I said, I have these three bags that I just got, but I also have another makeup bag, which I think I have, I'm pretty sure I have shown it on a video. And a pair of shoes. And I haven't really gotten the opportunity to use the shoes that often because I've been stuck inside the house. I mostly, in all fairness, I mostly use those to like go run errands, but they're perfect for that. But these bags, I'm obsessed with. I love their makeup bags. I have gotten a really good use out of the other one. And what I also like about these is that, for example, this one, this is like great for traveling because you know the whole like travel packing cubes and stuff that everyone keeps talking about, which I also want to get because it makes packing so much easier. This totally helps with that. Like if I wanted to, I can just put all my makeup brushes in here, put it in my my suitcase, and these I can put in my dope bag, and like it's perfect, you know. This I think I could also use this to put like passports, documents, maybe wires, like to recharge my phone. Or you know what? Even my camera will fit in here. My camera would totally fit in this bag, and that way it's not just kind of like bumping around. I could just pop it in here and it's perfect. Or, you know, I mean, I can use these bags on so many things, but the main reason that I purchased them was really for these two, the bigger ones, and I purchased them for my makeup. And this is kind of like an added bonus, which I'm really happy about. But yeah. Now, this is the unboxing for the day, and I'm also really happy. I love these. I don't think this is supposed to be the wash bag. Maybe it is, but look at this. Look at this. Look at this seam. That is just awesome. I'm really surprised by the craftsmanship. Really. And I don't think this has a false bottom or a... I think this is attached to it, so I'm good. Now, I did want to show you guys something. I got a boo-boo. So, I was ironing yesterday, and I was getting hot, so I rolled up my sleeves. And I wasn't paying attention, and for some reason, I reached over the ironing board, and look at what happened to me. Let me see if I can... Look at that. I burned myself. Now, and it was kind of gross because as soon as that happened, I literally heard my skin burn. It like gave off this sizzle, this like shh. So I knew my skin had burned before I even felt it. Now it's not as bad as I thought it was gonna be because it was hurting. So. While I took a break from ironing and I actually got these, what are they called? This ice pack, and I just put it on for a few minutes and then I finished ironing and then I went and I just sat on the couch with this ice pack. And I think that made a huge difference. I think it stopped my skin from continuing to burn. It kind of stopped that process, I guess. I don't know. And it also just kind of cooled down my skin. I've had these types of burns before, mostly from baking and cooking. This was the first time that I actually iced something. So, and before, like, you know, it would hurt all day, and then I would take a shower, and that water would hurt. Not this time, and I think it's because I iced it. The reason I iced it was because of the pain, but I also thought maybe like, you know, when you take something out of the oven and you want it to stop cooking because it's still hot, you put it in the fridge, and that kind of stops. so much for watching. I hope you liked this video. Give me a thumbs up if you did. Subscribe if you want to see more of my content. And look in the description box. I'm going to try to give you guys a